mighty happy, happy time. And this is a great company, and Mr. Ruiz, I'm so happy you started it, and so proud that your children are making it even stronger. And now you're part of our lives and our community in South Carolina and Florence. I've been over here so many times lately on growth and expansion and happy things. It really is just a thrill. But some of you may not know, my mama and daddy were both born in Florence, so I'm qualified to be here sometime. But this is a great part of the state. As Mr. Reese said a little while ago, as we were coming in, the people of South Carolina are different. And I've been, in the last 2.5, 3 years, had the opportunity to talk to a lot of big companies that are coming to South Carolina. And this is Mercedes and Schaeffler and BMW and all these others, Volvo, Boeing, all of them. And they all talk about the reasons that they come to South Carolina. And it's in the conversation, they always mention the port, which is going to begin dredging again in October. It's going deep water. We'll be able to handle the biggest boats in the world day and night. They also mention the technical college system that we started in 1961. Some states don't even have a technical college system. We've got one that is mature and is supercharged. And began then and is working all across the state. They mentioned that. They mentioned plentiful power, electrical power. They mentioned the people. Always. And that's the thing. And the chairman of BMW said at their 25th anniversary in Spartanburg the other day, he said, I've been all over the world and all over the country, all over the United States. And when we expand somewhere, when we build somewhere, and you know, in Spartanburg, they produce more BMWs there than any place in the world. A new BMW rolls off the line every 61.7 seconds in Spartanburg, South Carolina. But he says, of all the places I have been, South Carolina is the only handshake state. That means the people here will do, the workers, the people, the leaders, the business leaders, political leaders, all of them, will do what they say they're going to do. And they do it well, and they do it with pride. So the success that we're having in South Carolina is something that's not a recent success. The seeds, the vision for what is happening now in South Carolina were planted a long time ago. And now they've developed full-fledged. Some folks say when we finally invented air conditioning, that's what really opened us up here in South Carolina. Might be something to that, but with the mountains and the oceans and all that we have in that great harbor, a great attitude about business, and it's always the people. You just can't beat this place. Y'all remember the little story about as a teenager working in the summer down at Hawley's Island somewhere cutting grass, and some visitors came up Highway 17 and wanted to know where Sandy Island was. And he said, well, sir, you go up here, you take Waverly Road. No, that's not it. Take a Pettigrew and you go about, says, no, that's not it. Says, sir, I hate to tell you, you just can't get that from here. Well, I'm here to tell you this, in South Carolina, you can get anywhere from here. And that's one reason that Reese is here. And we are proud of them. This will be 700 new jobs on top of 500 already. This is a multi-million dollar investment. Other companies are doing the same thing. This company here produces more Mexican frozen food than anybody in the whole country. And we like to think that we produce the best people in the whole country. And we're delighted to be your partners. Just a couple of other quick points. Since January of 2017, that's when I came in as governor. And again, I must say, building on the success that others, the decisions and vision that others, many of whom are right here, planted and started us on the right course. We have announced 7,500 new jobs just since January, investments of over $2.2 billion. Q-Weather's agriculture is a $41.7 billion industry with 212,000 jobs. This is the perfect place for a company like Reese and for people like this. Our people are resilient, they're strong, they're they're smart, they show up, and they're proud of their work. And you just don't get any better than that. So on behalf of the state government and the people of South Carolina, let me say to you, would anybody like some candy? We'll have plenty later. Let me say thank you on your decision. Congratulations on your fine work. Congratulations on a great company. And because we can't get anywhere from here, South Carolina, Greece, we're going right straight to the top. Thank you.